Hey guys, what is up? My name is Megan and welcome back to my channel, or welcome if you're new. I hope you guys are doing well and staying safe, and welcome to today's video, which is my summer reading list. Essentially, this is a list of all the books that are not on my planned TBRs that I would like to get to between the months of July and like early to mid-September before the chilly air comes back and we are all into our fall reading mojos. Summer is my favorite season. I have a lot of books that I want to read, but I kind of narrowed the list down to a little bit of like a few different genres, what I could typically be in the mood for in the summer, and just books that I really, really want to get to or I'm excited to, like, continue series and such. So, as I mentioned, there's a variety of genres. We have some romance, some middle grade, thrillers, a little bit of fantasy, some literary fiction. It's all jumbled together, but we're gonna separate them by genres here, starting with romance. The first romance books I want to get to are actually all in a companion series, and it is the remainder of the Campus a Wallflower series by Rebecca Jenchak. I read Tutoring the Player, and I talked about this in my mid-year book freakout tag if you haven't seen it, but I am now obsessed with her, and so for me the right way of doing it is just to like finish that companion series, and then when fall rolls around we'll move into all of her hockey romances. So what I have to read are Hating the Player, Scoring the Player, and Tempting the Player. These are all like college romances, and Campus Wallflowers are essentially, we follow a main group of girls who are all wallflowers, and the boys are all parts of like sports clubs. The first one was hockey, but they're not all like jocks in the same way, so I can't wait to binge read these. I had tabbed the crap out of Tutoring the Player as well, so I can't wait to do that. Not with my special edition copies, but with the regular copies I own of these books. But these are definitely a main priority and something I am incredibly excited to binge. Sitting in my hammock with a good drink and a snack, it's gonna be the time of my life. It is the definition of summer. Speaking of definition of summer, let me show you guys what else I want to read. In that mid-year book freakout tag, I also mentioned how I have been falling in love with Stephanie Archer because I have been reading her Queen's Cove series and obviously would like to continue them as well. I technically own In Your Dreams, Holden Roads. This is, I believe, the third book. I know I purchased them a little bit out of order, but I think this is the third. However, I am, and I realized this like today, missing the fourth book. I never purchased the fourth book because I got all of these on sale and the fourth just never goes on sale. So I don't know, because I've been trying to reduce the amount of books I purchase for myself, if I'm just gonna leave it on the wish list and just read the third book. But again, the completionist side of me really wants to read the fourth. Either way, this is a small town like romance series set in Queen's Cove. Stephanie Archer is Canadian, and it's just the way she writes her books and describes like the weather and the scenery feels very comforting and like at home, and so the vibes are just immaculate for the summertime. I read That Kind of Guy and The Wrong Mr. Right, absolutely loved both of them, so this is definitely up there on my list of priorities as well. And again, just like I will be doing with Rebecca, I plan on reading her hockey series in the fall. I have three more romance books on my list, one being Cross the Line by Simone Soltani. This is the gorgeous Afterlight edition, and basically this is a Formula One romance, which I have been craving a good Formula One romance, but I'm not ready to venture into Lauren Asher's Formula One romance because I don't also want to be emotional. I just want to have a fun time, and I think this will give it to me. And this is between, I think, a Formula One driver and a like girl who just graduated college who does social media. They work together to fix his image in return for something for her, obviously, and end up falling in love at the same time. I have been waiting for this release for a while, and I'm incredibly excited for this one. Then, speaking of Lauren Asher, I decided to go with her Love Redesigned. I don't know what the series is called, but the second book, Love Unwritten, just came out. These are chunky romances. Like, the second book is over 600 pages. I don't know why they're this long. But this is a, like, family frenemies and, like, rivals that team up to remodel this home in order to, like, make profit. I don't know why they end up working together, but I know the boy in here is a billionaire, so it's a billionaire romance, and honestly, I could eat this up, and it's dual perspective. I already know I love Lauren Asher. I love all the billionaire men she writes, and so I think I'm gonna have an incredibly fun time reading this. I can visualize myself again in my hammock or by the beach reading this and having a grand old time. The vibes are vibing with this one. And then I know I've been saying, like, I'll keep hogging romances for the fall. However, there's one in particular that I've been wanting to read for a really long time. And the reason I want to read the series now, with this one being the first, The Punking Wrong Number by C.R. Jane, is because these covers are going out of print. I have the first two indie covers, and technically there is a third, again, trying to save money, but before these go out of print, I need to make my decision if I love these enough to, like, bite the bullet right now and purchase it. It's another book that's, like, it's on my wish list. Oh, what am I gonna do? But this is, again, so many of my favorite tropes. I can't believe I haven't read this already. It's, like, a anonymous texting, like, wrong texting, like, you're texting the wrong person vibe, so it's, and then they're obviously gonna meet. I don't know. I think they meet in real life and they don't know that they're each other, or no, I lied. They end up texting. The guy who's a famous hockey player doesn't want to give his last name. And then I think he becomes obsessed with her. I don't know, you guys. I just know I'm gonna eat this up. Everybody has been obsessed and, like, collecting all the editions that have been made of this book. So I feel like it talks for itself. So that was the last romance book on my list, and that was a terrible description of it, but moving on, let's do middle grade next. We have three middle grade books on the list because I already have a lot to read with my book club and everything else I have going on. But the first book on my list is Crookhaven, The School for Thieves. This is the first book in a middle grade series. I have been wanting to read this for a while. I have put this in polls for middle grade book club. It never wins, so I came to the conclusion that I'm gonna read this one by myself. This follows a main character named Gabriel, who is recruited to Crookhaven, which is a school for thieves. Basically, it's like a secret school that trains students in classes like forgery, deception, and other things, and it sounds like it's gonna be chaotic and fun, because, like, a school to learn deception and, like, learn how to do bad things, but, like, the catchphrase is, here we will teach you to do wrong, but only so that one day you will put the world right. I am intrigued. Is this a chosen one trope? I don't know. I'm gonna figure it out. Then we have the sequel to The Mistwick School of Musicraft, which I have a full review of if you want to hear more about this series. But ideally, I would like to read the second book because the third has come out on audio, or is coming out. I think it's come out. And I want to keep this series fresh in my brain because I absolutely loved my time with the first one. And so it's on hand. All I can do is read it, but I will need to purchase the audio for these because the audiobooks are absolutely fantastic. And the last book I want to read that is middle grade is Impossible Creatures by Catherine Rundle. I have the beautiful Waterstones edition of this, and it's signed. Like, this book is literally stunning. This is about a young boy who ends up being swept away in a new world where there's, like, dragons and all kinds of things. And I know some people who watch my channel who have similar taste to me in middle grade have told me I'm gonna love this. It was close to winning the poll for the book club pick this time around, but it still hasn't. So I'm done waiting for it to be a book club pick, and again, I'm just gonna pick it up by myself. These books are all pretty short. I mean, the Midnight Orchestra is a little bit thicker, but with the audiobook, it's gonna fly by. So I think I could definitely manage these three during the summer. I think I have a few thrillers and literary fiction left, so let's do those. The one, like, fantasy, adult fantasy book I have is Romantasy, and it is Blood Mercy by Vila Roth. This is a chunker. It's how many pages? Like, over 600 pages, and it is the first book in a series. I have talked about how excited I am for this, even though it's a little less my usual cup of tea. I really strongly believe that this is going to be the romantasy for me. I don't know why. Is it the cover? Is it what I've heard people say about it? I just have a feeling that this one might be it. I might be a Vila Roth girly. Honestly, kind of wish I am, because these covers are stunning and the books are thick. So when you're immersed in a book and you get to enjoy it for a while, I think it's a really fun time. So this, again, is a perfect vacation read, because when I'll have more time, I have a few weeks off in the month of July. Hopefully, I can get through this. This is an ambitious one. It might be pushed back to the fall, but I want to read it. Then we have some literary fiction, one which I've talked about a lot, again, that I haven't had time to read, or haven't taken the time to read, is Remarkably Bright Creatures by Shelby Van Pelt. This is about a woman whose husband dies. She works at this, like, aquarium and bonds with an octopus, and you follow both the octopus points of view and the lady. I think I'm gonna cry at this. I just have the best feeling, and I don't know, the cover, the vibe, it just feels like literary fiction you read in the summer. And then something that is definitely outside of my comfort zone is Chlorine by Jade Song, and this is a blurring of the lines between literary coming-of-age narrative and a dark, unsettling horror tale. Chlorine is a story about the trials and tribulations of growing up in a society that puts pressure on young women and their bodies. Told from an adult perspective, a powerful, relevant debut novel of immigration, sapphic longing, and fierce, defiant becoming. I could not make a better synopsis for this. It's short. Thank God, because I don't know what I'm getting myself into. I am scared incredibly easy, but I think this is like summer vibes again, because it has those like mermaid weird vibes. Maybe this is gonna be like a revelation and I'm gonna be absolutely obsessed, or I'm gonna question every single ounce of my being for having this book. Moving on to thrillers, because I love a good thriller or two during the summertime. Like, the top priority for me is Bright Young Women by Jessica Knoll. I have been wanting to get this book for a really long time, and now I have it, and I still haven't read it. This is, like, surrounding serial killers. It's fiction, but I think it's based on our reality. I know what this book is about, but again, it's one I'm having a really difficult time pitching and kind of creating a synopsis for, so I'm gonna go in, and once I've read it, obviously will tell you all my thoughts, but I'm very hopeful that I will get to this summer. I just feel like I'm in the mood for like a thriller that is gonna satisfy the itch, because I've been reading a few thrillers here and there. None of them have satisfied me in a way that like some thrillers I've read in the past have, so I'm still on the lookout for a really good thriller. The other thriller I want to read is more, I guess it's a mystery thriller, is the reappearance of Rachel Price. I always call her Rachel Prince, but it's Rachel Price by Holly Jackson. I have this book. I don't know where it went on my shelves. Don't have the urge to pick them apart, so here's a picture. I love Holly Jackson. I really loved her Good Girl's Guide to Murder. Liked Five Survive, and so here we are with this. I don't really know where I'm going to go with this, but I hope I really enjoy it. I've heard some great things. I am planning on tandem reading the book physically and listening to it via audio. I might also do that with Bright Young Women as well, because the audio is on BookBeat as well. So those are like the thrillers I'm in the mood for, and that pretty much completes my summer reading list. I do think there's a good foray of genres, obviously a little bit more romance heavy because I am a romance and middle grade reader at heart, but romance definitely, like, the itch is there in the summertime because it's just so wonderful to, like, sit in the sun and read a romance and question all your life choices and, you know, wishing that fictional men were real when they're not. So that's it for the video. Let me know in the comments down below what you guys want me to prioritize and what your summer reading list is, and I'll see you very soon with another video. Bye guys, happy reading.